Of your dreams. Pre-design and planning is $750 value. The Manhattan Club is giving away $1,000 travel gift certificate gift baskets. Enter to win. They're located next to the Public Safety Communication Mobile Unit. The drawing is Saturday and Sunday. I should say today, Sunday, noon, coming up here in less than a half an hour and 4 p.m. Get over to their booth and enter to win. The aircraft that just took off is the United States Army Golden Knights Parachute Team aircraft, their C-31 Friendship aircraft. And they will be coming back through in just a couple of minutes to do what is known as a very, very high rate of speed of 120 miles per hour. If they are members of your United States Army Parachute Team, the Golden Knights, here they come right now.
Guys, watch that thing there.
And right now we've got a canopy open. Members of your United States Army Parachute Team, the Golden Knights. These are members of, this is a member of the Black Demonstration Team of the Golden Knights. One of six different parts of the Golden Knights that comprise 90 soldiers working out of their home at Fort Bragg, North Carolina. This is one of the female members of the team. Her name is Brandy Phillips. With a forward speed of about 22 miles per hour, she's on her way in right now. Spirals down, reaching speeds of about 60 miles per hour, losing altitude very rapidly and flying today the POWMIA flag. These parachutes are very, very maneuverable, as you can see. They actually use the same method, however, of steering that the Wright brothers used on their first airplane over 100 years ago. They actually change the shape of the wing by warping it. They call it wing warping. In this case, Brandy Phillips is changing the shape of her wing to allow her to turn right or left or spiral down very, very rapidly. Now, we've got close to 100,000 people here today. What I'd love for you to do is start to make some noise, because she'll actually be able to hear you. She's working on landing on a spot in the center of the target. So let's make some noise for Brandy as she comes in on the target. They're in the center of that X. There is a small black dot about 2.5 inches in diameter. She'll turn into the wind. Watch her use her arms to guide herself right in on target. Ladies and gentlemen, from 12,500 feet above the ground to a dead center landing, Brandy Phillips of the Golden Knights. Let's hear it all the way up and down the line. Make some big noise for her. A fantastic jump.
Soldiers have forged for themselves a place of honor in America's hearts. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Sergeant Brady Phillips, originally from the Dumper Morale, and the smoke is on. We now have members of the Golden Knights rapidly approaching speeds of 120 miles an hour. The initial part of the formation is called the base and it forms quickly as the initial jumpers fly their bodies together while interlocking their arms and legs to form the nucleus of the formation. The remaining jumpers set up slightly above and outside the formation awaiting the team leader's call. At 9,000 feet, the team leader waves his arms, signaling the outside jumpers to fly to the base. As they fly closer and closer together, they use their arms, legs, and shoulders as flight controls, allowing them to safely complete the formation. The formation continues to fly at 120 miles an hour as a free-fall photographer circles the formation. And there you have the high-flying black and gold of your United States Army parachute team, the Golden Knights. Now, as you may have guessed, these numbers are facing the unique situation, a traffic jam in the sky. They must first gain vertical separation to allow for individual approaches into the target area. To accomplish this, they pull on the front part of the parachute, spiraling down at speeds in excess of 60 miles per hour to set up a traffic pattern, much like you might see aircraft at a busy airport. Looking high overhead, it may appear that these canopies have become entangled, but that is not the case. These jumpers are actually performing a facet of a sport called canopy relative work. With the advanced aerodynamic design of these ram air parachutes, it is actually possible to fly one parachute right up into the hands of another jumper without adversely affecting its flight characteristics. The top jumper can then pull himself down his partner's line and even stand on his shoulders. Unlike free fall, these jumpers can carry on a conversation just like you and I standing here on the ground. It is the job of the bottom jumper, who is the navigator, to relay altitude readings and wind direction to the pilots. The average Golden Knight is 26 years old, has more than 1,200 parachute jumps, and is proficient in one of the hundreds of Army occupational skills. He or she joined the Army for a multitude of reasons: training, educational benefits, travel, excitement, adventure, and a chance to mature. In short, to get an edge on life. High standards identify the individual members of the United States Army parachute team. They are selected not only for their parachute skills, but also for their soldiering abilities as well. As Golden Knights, they are defenders, ambassadors, citizens in the uniform of the United States Army. The parachutes used by the Golden Knights are a flexible wing glider. Constructed of a lightweight, ripstop nylon, these parachutes have an inherent forward speed of 22 miles per hour. To turn left, the jumper will simply pull down on the left steering rod. To turn right, the jumper will simply pull down on the right steering rod. As these jumpers near the ground, they will pull down on both steering lines simultaneously for the safest and softest possible landing. At 1,000 feet, the jumper does what is called a wind penetration check, checking his distance and speed across the ground. He will then fly a downwind leg, a base leg 90 degrees to the target, then face into the wind for a final approach. It takes a great deal of concentration in order to land dead center on the target. The jumper keeps a close eye on the windsock located in the target area. Bringing it in first is our team leader. Watch as he makes minor corrections with his steering toggles, bringing it over the target for a nice, soft target landing. Following closely behind is the second jumper. You may notice he has 7 openings on the front of his canopy. These allow air to be forced in, inflating the flexible wing glider. Coming in third, flying the Army Star flag. Watch as they make minor corrections, bringing it over the target for a nice target landing. Yeah! You may notice the tail of this parachute curl under. This slows the jumper's forward speed while reducing their rate of descent. Watch as this jumper slows the forward speed of their canopy, making minor adjustments as they bring it over the target for a beautiful target landing. No. The United States Army parachute team is comprised mostly of non-commissioned officers. The 89 men and women of the Golden Knights come through various jobs throughout the Army, who spent 3 years on one of the 5 major sections of our team. Watch as these last jumpers bring it into the target area. setting it down for a beautiful target landing.
Okay, there's more.
He's splitting the target. Watch as they bring it down for a safe, soft landing. Finally, our last jumper brings it into the target area. He slows all the forward speed of his canopy, making minor adjustments. Bringing it over the target area for a nice target, stand up landing. As the last of the jumpers remove their equipment and don the distinctive maroon beret of today's modern airborne paratrooper, I would like to introduce the jumpers in order of the performance. But first, performing the difficult duties of ground control. From Quincy, Massachusetts, he is an airborne army recruiter with 5 freefall parachute jumps, Sergeant First Class Rob Mooney. Assisting him in the difficult duties of ground control from Houston, Texas, he is an airborne ranger with 836 freefall parachute jumps, Staff Sergeant Trevor Oppenborn. Performing the technical duties of freefall photographer from Gilroy, California, he is an airborne infantryman with 2,782 freefall parachute jumps, Staff Sergeant Ben Forger. Flying the difficult position of outside cameraman from Los Angeles, California, he is an airborne infantryman with 13,187 freefall parachute jumps, Sergeant First Class Eric Heinheimer. Also with us this weekend, from Buffalo, New York, he is a Special Forces officer and the commander of the United States Army Parachute Team with 554 freefall parachute jumps, Lieutenant Colonel Joe Martin. And now for the jumpers. Hailing from Alton, New Hampshire, he is an airborne ranger with 978 freefall parachute jumps, Staff Sergeant Howard Sanborn. Coming to you from Eureka, California, she is an airborne combat medic with 1,027 freefall parachute jumps, Sergeant Rachel Medley. Out of Vancouver, British Columbia, he is an airborne parachute maintenance technician with 728 freefall parachute jumps, Sergeant First Class Arlen Slade. All the way from Massillon, Ohio, he is an airborne infantryman with 1,734 freefall parachute jumps, Staff Sergeant Todd Beckel. Hailing from North Richland Hills, Texas, he is an airborne infantryman and an assistant team leader of the Black Demonstration Team with 2,247 freefall parachute jumps, Staff Sergeant Brandon Valley. Coming to you from Stone Mountain, Georgia, he is an airborne ranger with 3,279 freefall parachute jumps, Staff Sergeant Joe Jones. Hailing from Gloucester, Virginia, he is an airborne Black Hawk crew chief with 537 freefall parachute jumps, Sergeant Tyler Wheeler. And leading the Golden Knights in freefall, he is a team leader of the Black Demonstration Team. From Los Angeles, California, he is an airborne ranger with 5,974 freefall parachute jumps, Sergeant First Class Will Fleming. Ladies and gentlemen, please pull out your cameras. You do not want to miss this unique photo opportunity. Ladies and gentlemen, it gives me great pleasure to present to you the Black Demonstration Team for the 2010 air show season. All members of your United States Army Parachute Team, the Golden Knights.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, from the left, being flown by Ron Turner and David Clay, here comes the C-31 Friendship aircraft of the Golden Knights. Get your cameras ready as it does a high-speed pass right over top of the Black Demonstration Team of the Golden Knights. Let's hear it.
Now, in keeping with the long-standing Golden Knight tradition, we would like to present today's baton, which was flown in freefall to a distinguished member of today's audience. Senior Airman Nicholas Winters has stepped forward and been introduced to our team leader. He will be presented with today's baton and meet each of the individual team members. Senior Airman Winters deployed to Kuwait in support of Operation Iraq.